Good afternoon. I'm Laura Galluzzo from Politecnico di Milano, and I'm presenting a paper of me and Agnese Rebaglio, who teaching at Politecnico of Milano. The lecture is about the result of projects from a design studio bachelor's of science in interior design. The title of the presentation is New Generation, because the target of the project is young people, and the aim of research is to design a city of youth. And this theme is reconnected to the subject of the outdoor exhibition in urban context, that is the presentation was presenting by Davide Fassi 4 years ago in Bangkok for the Transurban conference. And they are connected because the two research take place in the same town, in Sesto San Giovanni near Milan, and the context is similar, is in the north of Italy, is in Lombardia, a historical very industrialized area, and one of most productivity region on the of Italy. Sesto San Giovanni represents very well the industrial industrialization period of last century, when people moved from country to the town to work in the factories. And this town increased its population very fast to 41,000 inhabitants. And the ex-Breda area is one of the most important factory of the town. The other one is the Falck Society, and is a place where now is designing a project Renzo Piano. The Breda area, it's really it represents very well the industry, the industrial buildings, because in the exteriors we can find a tower of models, a gantry crane, and very big buildings, and the total area covered 3 million of square meters. And the landscape is created by typical industrialization building. And the interior, the same, the huge interiors, and with a warehouse with shed-like roofs. And it's really interesting how the light comes inside the buildings, and it's a sort of contemporary cathedral, I think. It's really interesting for this reason. And we worked with the same approach. If we worked in a typical historical center of a town, an Italian town, so because these buildings are an example of archaeological industrial industries. Our purpose is to transform from a city of factories to a factory of ideas. A sort of city of creativity. And we worked with this 60 interior design students for 6 months, and after we select 8 projects, and they are in the exhibition outside in the courtyard. And the idea is to design a city for young people from young designer. And so it's really interesting, because the young designers can understand very well the needs and the desire from young people to young people. I think the principal need is to create relationship, to meet other people, and so for that it's really important to design the space and the connecting the areas. And in all the big interior exterior that the Breda area has, and we choose 7 different functions. We have the spaces for events and exhibition in the area of Ghent Ukraine and in all the passage and path in the exteriors. And after we have also accommodating space in the Tower of Models and to do the possibility to guys that work and in the city to sleep and eat inside the city. Of youth. And also there are the spaces for the music workshop and for a new media lab like movie design, TV, photography workshop, and also for theater and artistic activity like writing and readings. There are also the spaces for design. So it's really interesting because the young designer imagine the spaces to do the design. So it's really interesting to imagine where we want to work and where we want to meet other people, where we want to expose our project. And this is the plan of the area with the different functions. And now I'm presenting the 8 projects that are in the exhibition. The first 2 projects are about the first function. The spaces for events and exhibition, and they worked on the connective space to create the path and the places where people can meet and can expose their project. The same theme for this project. Is an expositive space in the zone of Ghent Ukraine and uses the principle of suspension of the Ghent Ukraine, but with another purpose to expose the object like this. Is a big open space covered. The second function, so the accommodating spaces, we have a project, this is a sort of covered camping and made of vertical sleeping bags. These elements represent a home abstraction or something like this. They are a sort of over totem object. And they referring to the sensation of wrapping spaces. And this is the space for the new media lab, and this project is for the photography lab. And the title, White and Black, is the title that suggests the traditional process to produce photos. And the big sphere, the big black sphere cut the building in 2 parts, and the sphere contains the dark rooms and exhibition space, and the other space is white in contrast with the black sphere. This is the space for artistic activities, and this work lights light shape is a space dedicated to the reading and write workshop. And the focus point of this project is the light that came from the roof of the shed. And the light stripes generate the architectural space. They make volumes appear. And inside the room, the provenance and the direction of light determines the layout and the furniture and the shape of the furniture. This is the space for the design workshop. And the main theme of this project is the connection. The intention is to create a network, and the starting point is a contradiction, because the corridor, the environment whose main function is connected and to orientate, is constituted by a disordered network of staircases, catwalks, and aerial walkways. And the communication system, like this, is that characterizes the environment of this corridor and plays the information and ordering functions, but still allows us to reflect on dispersion, disorder, and ambiguity. And the last project is the last one in the design area, but is an exhibition space. Is in front of the building of design workshop, and its position and its big shape, like a spiral, attract people to go inside to visit the exhibition. The objects are suspended inside the big shape. And that's all. Thank you.